Seeing an iceberg calve off into the ocean is a main attraction for a visitor to the glaciers of Svalbard, Greenland, Alaska, or any other similar place in the Arctic or Antarctica. It's amazing to see these massive, building-sized pieces of solid ice crack and tumble off a glacier, creating a large wave in the aftermath. However, icebergs are more than just a spectacle. They hold important clues about the glaciers that spawned them. And they also hold a surprising connection for those of us who live far from the poles. Tidewater glaciers are rivers of ice that flow all the way down into the ocean. At a certain point, the glacier ice can no longer sustain itself. This is seen at the glacier face. The position of the glacier face will be largely dependent on the ocean and air temperature. In a stable climate, the position of the glacier face will remain more or less fixed, with seasonal variations retreating back in the warmer summer months and advancing forward in the colder winter months. Although the face of the glacier may remain in a more or less fixed position, the glacier is still flowing forward and down into the ocean. As this happens, icebergs will break off in a process known as calving. They come in a large range of sizes and shapes. Off the coast of Antarctica or Greenland, we see massive icebergs that are the size of a city block or even larger. The video clips and images in this film show icebergs on a smaller scale near the Kronebreen, Kongsvegen and Kongsbreen glaciers in Svalbard, Norway. You may think of ice as being transparent and accumulated snow as being white, but glaciers contain a variety of colors. The color of the ice depends on whether the ice is deep inside the glacier or has been in contact with the surface for a while. The colors within the glacier also reflect the type and amount of sediment embedded within the glacier. Some icebergs appear quite blue, while others are more white. This has to do with the exposure of the glacier ice to the air. As glaciers form from the buildup of snow over hundreds or thousands of years, this snow will compress into dense solid ice. The blue color comes about as the crystalline structure of the ice changes under compression. Snow appears white because most of the visible colors are scattered by the snow crystals. As the ice compresses and the ice crystals change, the ice will absorb longer wavelengths of light, such as red, orange, and yellow. But the ice will scatter the shorter wavelengths, such as blue, to our eyes. So glacier ice appears blue. Glacier ice contains many tiny air bubbles. Because of the immense weight of the ice, these tiny air bubbles are under pressure. The closer they are to the surface, the more ice will crack open and this pressure will be relieved. At this point, the slightly more expanded, fractured ice will scatter more wavelengths of light and will appear white once again. When you spend time in a place like Kongsfjord, Svalbard, where we were studying these glacier systems, sometimes on a calm day, you can literally hear the cracking and popping sound of icebergs fracturing as the compressed air bubbles within them expand. Icebergs that retain their vibrant blue color likely come from the deeper parts of the glacier and have separated from the main body of the glacier relatively recently. Icebergs will often change from blue as they sit in the ocean over many hours or days. In addition to white and blue, icebergs often contain brown, black, and gray. These colors come from the sediment stuck in the icebergs. As glaciers develop and flow across the landscape, they break up the rock beneath them, and enormous amounts of sediment accumulate within the mass of ice. You may have heard the phrase, "That's just the tip of the iceberg." This phrase comes from the fact that in a freely floating iceberg, only around 10% of the actual iceberg floats above the surface of the water. Generally, the temperature of the ocean water is warmer than that of the iceberg, which will eventually cause the iceberg to melt. The iceberg may not melt in a uniform way, and cracks or weaknesses in the iceberg may cause it to break apart in unpredictable ways. As a result, icebergs often shift or roll as they search for a new equilibrium. This makes many icebergs extremely unstable. A simple and fun tool called Iceberger, created and made available by Josh Tauberer, allows a user to test out two-dimensional shapes of icebergs to see how they float. This simple tool gives an idea of which types of icebergs are stable and which are unstable. Because of their instability, icebergs can flip and, when they do, reveal the bottom of the glacier they came from. It's even possible to sample the sediment captured in these icebergs to make inferences about the source of the bedrock and the dynamics of the glacier itself. As icebergs break apart and melt, their sediments are deposited onto the seafloor. These sediments are known as ice rafted debris, or IRD. Looking for IRDs can be a useful tool for geologists reconstructing the climate history of the Earth. For example, scientists studying sediment cores in the North Atlantic can look at the presence or absence of IRDs to make inferences about when ice sheets covered certain areas of Europe or North America. During colder glacial periods when ice sheets were growing, there was less iceberg calving, and so therefore less ice-rafted debris observed in the sediment record. However, as the climate warmed at the end of a glacial period and into an interglacial period, the amount of icebergs increased along with the ice-rafted debris they were carrying. Icebergs can also reveal what is going on with the way water moves through a glacier. Glaciers contain quite a bit of fresh water, which runs through conduits close to the base of the glacier. Eventually, many of these high-pressure rivers will exit the glacier at the glacier face. As this happens, the meltwater exits in what are called upwelling plumes. Because the water in ice is fresh water, which is less dense than the salty ocean water, when the water from the subglacial river hits the ocean water, this freshwater rises quickly to the top of the water column. It is also under enormous pressure, so it comes out with tremendous force. The brown color comes from the fine-grained glacial sediment eroded by the glacier and carried down to the ocean by the fast-moving subglacial river. This fast, vertically moving water carves out ice on the face of the glacier, leaving behind vertical grooves called runnels. Investigating these runnels in icebergs can give clues about the internal plumbing of the glacier. There is evidence to suggest that as the climate warms, the rate of iceberg calving may be increasing. Certainly, many glaciers are flowing faster as the temperature warms, and at the same time, more tidewater glaciers are retreating and thinning. But measuring the rate of iceberg calving worldwide is not an easy task to quantify. If the number of icebergs spawned by glaciers is increasing, then this could have some major effects. The increase in freshwater in the ocean and the change in ocean surface temperature locally in the polar regions could disrupt the circulation of the ocean, which has depended on a stable influx of meltwater for several thousands of years. This could have large effects on the climate of Europe and North America, and possibly other parts of the world as well. Eventually, as tidewater glaciers retreat onto land and they lose their ability to create icebergs, then even more dramatic effects will be in store. While icebergs and the sediments they leave behind can teach us about the past, it may surprise you to realize that we who live in lower latitudes are directly connected to the future of icebergs. The actions we take to emit more or less greenhouse gases into the atmosphere will affect the degree to which future observers will be able to enjoy the thrill of watching an iceberg form and the degree to which our climate remains stable.